Hi, hello. In this video, we are going to discuss about electrocution. And here, first and foremost, what are the types of current and what are the basic differences between them and which is fatal, which is non-fatal, which is less likely to cause injury has been discussed in the initial part of a video and followed by the factors that are determining causing a electrical injury and followed by the treatment and management of the individual and autopsy findings in detail, the external and internal findings, and in external, what are the characteristic type of injuries that could be caused as a result of electrocution has been discussed. Can result in both non-fatal and fatal injuries. And in electrical injury is mainly obtained from chemical, from mechanical as well as light energy. Where an electrical energy is being obtained, and when and where an individual gets electrocuted, he sustains an electrical burns or a characteristic type of the injuries all over his body and mostly over the point of contact and point of exit, and it produces a unique type of thermal injury on the individual. And the sources of electrocution could be often during a domestic supply, or in case of an industrial accident, or during any commercial transport mode of supplies, which there been a break and which has resulted in injuries, or an electricity distribution system, or by through process of lightning. And these all injuries are constituted, and these are the most common sources by which an individual can be electrocuted. And here, electrical injury. First and foremost is the kind of energy. Second, the amount of current that has been passed within the body. Third, the path or the course of current, which is on the due course on the travel within the body from the point of entry to the point of exit. What are the structures it has passed through and the primary contact area. And it also determines the characteristic features of an electrical injury. And four, the duration of the current flow. How long there been a contact between an individual and the electrical supply, and the resistance offered by the skin and other soft tissues. And if there been a greater resistance that has been offered, then the chances of getting burns or extreme degrees of burns are more likely. And the last point, the site of contact. Based on the site of contact, and indirectly determines the path of the current, and we will discuss each one of them in detail. Foremost, the type of current. And here in type of current, the current can be of two types. One is alternating current, another is a direct current, AC and DC. And the DC are less dangerous when you compare to a AC current. And in a DC current, the electricity flows constantly in a same direction, where in case of an AC, the alternating current, the current flows alternatively in opposite direction. So the point here you need to remember is DC is less dangerous than an alternating current. Factor is amount of current that has been passed through the body. And here the equation is A is equal to V by R, and A stands for the ampere, V for the voltage, and R for the resistance. And here the ampere is more important, where it indicates the actual intensity or the total amount of electricity which has been passing through the body. And if there been an increase in voltage, and obviously the ampere, the flow of current within the body increases. And in case if there been a decrease in resistance, then again the flow of current is greatly increased. And here some numerical data to remember. Electrocution depth less than 100 voltage of current passage least likely to cause death, and if it is greater than 200 voltage, the most likely a death can occur. And third determining factor is path of current. The direction of the current that has been traveled with is determining the path of the current, the direction or the flow of the current. And if there been an intervention, or if the electricity or the current wave that is likely to pass through on a brainstem or heart is more likely to be fatal in nature. And if in this case where the point of entry is the entry mark is on by the right hand, and point of entry being right hand, and the point of exit being, or the point of grounding being, on the left foot, and the direction or the flow of current, either it could passes through the, either it can passes and it can passes through the heart, and it can leave on the portion of exit on the lower part of his left limb, or otherwise if there be no grounding, then the path of current can go to an other opposite counterpart of the opposite limb, and again if there been a grounding, and it can passes through, and in course of time where it passes through the heart, and heart can go for an a phase of ventricular fibrillation, and followed by paralysis of respiratory muscles can occur, and if there been a hold as a result of hold or a firm contact between the conductor and the arm of the individual, then it can even result in muscle spasm and other. And in second scenario, where the path of entry or the point of contact being the scalp region of the individual, and there been a overhead current live wire, and there been a contact where a current wave passes through, and it passes through the respiratory system or the respiratory center that has been located in the brain, and whereby it causes paralysis and a sudden death can occur, and a pathway of current or the mode of exit could be on the counter left lower limb, and purely it vary from one to another, and based on the contact and based on the resistance that has been offered by the skin over the local area. And here the fourth determining factor is duration of the current flow, and severity is directly proportionate to the duration of the current flow, and in case if there been a increased duration, then it is more likely to cause a death. Second factor is the resistance that has been offered by the body barriers like skin and part of dermis. Once the current, electric current, has passed beyond these layers, then the current can easily flow through the electrons rich fluid or through the bloodstream easily. And if there been a greater resistance that has been offered, then the individual more likely to suffer from burns. And here other examples could be of, if there been a point of entry being a dry skin offers high resistance, and but in case of a wet or an otherwise an a moist or an a covered an area that has been covered with an a sweat will offer a decreased resistance, and even the blood has a low resistance. And here in case if there been a high offering of resistance, then the secondary burning or a burn thermal injury is more likely to occur. This screen safety and rescuing the individual from the site of or the source of impact. And if a victim is been held in contact with the source of electricity, he should not be pulled off with a bare hand, and the current, prior to that, the current should be switched off, and followed by the individual can be moved from the site. And during on the course, the rescuer must wear a rubber shoe and a glove and attempt to remove him from the source. And defibrillation and other CPR and other respiratory support are giving an artificial respiration, and closed cardiac massages can be done as a part of an emergency measure or a part of a first aid to recover a individual from the state of injury. Prior to autopsy, prior to commencement of an autopsy, it is a duty of an RMP to ask for scene of death photographs, if it is available, the body and the nearby electrical equipments and the electrical circuits near to the body to be photographed along with the deceased. And here the body and the scene and any nearby electrical devices to be photographed. And regarding the examination of the electrical equipments, at the scene of crimes, right? And we lack knowledge about electrical equipments and other. It is the duty of an investigating officer to check for was there been any short circuit or any sort of faulty techniques or faulty machineries or faulty devices, wiring, and those again. It is not of our business. It is our duty of a police officer or the person who is involving in crime scene investigation. Their role to look for the deficient of electrical devices, equipments at scene of crime. And in autopsy, right? And in autopsy again, by reading the documents and etc. And then we enter into autopsy room for a complete autopsy. First and foremost, on the external findings, we need to look for electrical entry mark, electrical exit mark, and third is any other associated or any other external findings that can be significant towards an electrocution injury. And in first and foremost, it is electrical entry mark. And in electrical entry mark, the characteristic wound or the characteristic type of injury that has been sustained by individual can be termed as Joule burns, flash or otherwise spark burns, and electrical splits. And in electrical splits, the other name is any sort of irregular lacerated injury have been classified under electrical splits. And in case of flash or otherwise spark burns, exogenous burns that has been sustained have been termed as flash or spark burns. And in case of Joule burns, the other name is endogenous burns. And first and foremost, it is about in Joule burns, again, the other name is endogenous burns. And Joule burns are otherwise endogenous burns. And the most common presentation of a Joule burn injury is formation of crater on the point of entry. And the shape of the wound, it is round or otherwise oval shallow in shape. And the diameter or the dimension of the injury is 1 to 3 centimeter, and the ridge of the skin, which is about 1 millimeter high around the part of a crater. And here, to be in simpler words, there will be a certain sort of a depression on the point of entry. In literally, there will be palla mari or formation, adha suthiyum or made mari or rim mari form aayirukum inga areas and at the base of the site of injury. It may be pale or otherwise hypermic in nature, and the ridge or the periphery area may be blanched due to local atrial spasm as a result of a flow of current. And to be in simpler words, Joule burn is otherwise known as endogenous burns. And the Joule burns are typically produced in case of a low voltage current, and low voltage currents are more frequent in household supplies. And here the mechanism began when there been a contact with an electrical conductor, where there been a localized production of heat at the point of impact. And here the electrical energy has been converted into an heat energy within the tissue spaces, and it classically produces an endogenous burns or an localized lesion on the point of entry. And occasionally, in some rare circumstances, where marks of injury, where the entry mark or the crater formation may resemble the shape of the conductor or the shape of the source of the electrocution device. And this is the classical appearance of a crater injury. And other are extremely, right, extremely, it is not of that of a classical injury, but relatively a point of entry and it also appears to be in a crater, and here can able to see a minimal depression and relatively a raised ridges around the part of a from the base of the injury, and again base has been pale and there been associated injury and there been oozing at the point of entry. Again a typical crater, right, and a raised ridges and there been a localized depression and there been associated epidermal peeling also seen. And coming to other characteristic features of a jewel burn, and here it can present as a crater, right, that has been discussed in previous slide. And here the other forms of characteristic appearance of a jewel burn could be of a broken blister, or it may appear like an incised wound or otherwise an electrical split, and charring effect, local charring effect may be seen. And in case of broken blisters, initially may it appears as a blister due to repeated contact or repeated handling. The blister may break into on the course of traveling or on the course of handling of the deceased dead body, and it appears like a collapsed blister. And where in case of an electrical splits, it may appear like an incised wound or otherwise an irregular lacerated injury. And in cases it may mimic like, right, it may mimic like it could be caused by a sharp object or otherwise a hard object if there been a irregular margin lacerated injury. And in case of charring, if there been a high resistance that has been offered, then there will be an localized charring effect on that point of impact, right? And when does high resistance occur? Only when there been a dry skin, right? Dry skin offers high resistance, so there is a maximum chances of getting charring or blackening effect on that part at the point of impact. And other term that has been described while reading with jewel burn is metallization, right? Metallization is nothing but the some sort of a color deposition as a result of a passage of electricity. Some part of a tissue, yes, it adopts or it deposits as a result according to the characteristic feature of a conductor. If it been an aluminium conductor, then it produces a silvery appearance or silvery staining on point of entry. And in case of a copper based conductor, then it produces reddish brown color deposits or otherwise metallization in point of contact. And in case of iron, it produces brownish black appearances. And the reason being, it is due to the deposition of the metal. And here the principle is, when there been a contact, right, between two surfaces, mutual exchange of object from one to another, and the medical legal importance, right, it is a metallization is a definitive evidences that means the burn that has been produced as a result of electrical injury and not by any sort of flaming or any other forms of thermal death. And a test to determine metallization, right, the name of the test is acroreaction test, and it is a simpler microchemical test for detecting metals on a part of site of impact, right, and at the point of entry, right, otherwise, right, at the point of entry we can to detect metallization we need a test called acroreaction test, and it is only applicable for entry marks, not for exit marks. It means that if there been a doubt which is in a point of entry, point of exit, right, a localized tissue that has been resected during course of autopsy subjected for this acroreaction test, if a point of entry shows presence of metallization deposits, then it is in a point of entry, and in exit marks there will be no metallic reaction, right? And here a localized part that has been resected need to be subjected, or there should be few drops of hydrochloric acid or nitric acid to be poured, and followed by a portion of acid to be taken within a tiny wedge of a filter paper with a suitable reagent. There will be a production of color change, right? And from the previous slide, right? From the previous slide, if it has been silvery appearance, then the type of conductor is aluminium. And if it has been reddish brown, then it is of copper conductor. If it is of brownish black, then it is of iron conductor, and other etc. And what are the reasons where you can't see an electrical entry mark? Point of entry is not been detected even after a meticulous search for the entry mark. The reasons we get, it could be of a point of area being a large surface area. Large surface area is being a point of impact. So there is no evidence of an entry mark. And if in case, the second reason, it could be of a skin that has been offering a low resistance. Low resistance, it could be of a wet skin. Alright, a wet skin offers low resistance. So there is no any point of entry. And the third reason, it could be of a low voltage current. Low voltage current produce no entry mark. Alright. So to remember, need to remember 3 L's to remember this. A clear cut case of electrocution, but you can't make out a entry mark, and these are the exceptions for absence of an entry mark on the point of impact. The site of entry mark, right? Site of entry mark, most commonly it can be seen on the palmar aspects of fingers and hands. And here the upper limb, right? Take it as an upper limb where we need to look for point of entry. And other rare sites could be of an area over genital part or over the part of anus, right? And here, as a result of any methods of torture or as a result of an asexual perverted mind, these areas, again, areas of rarity. And if there be no entry marks, we also need to look these sites for presence of any entry marks. And in other cases, it may be seen even in underlying the intact cloth or under the hair, and especially over the part of a scalp hair where there been a contact between a live wire and above the head could be the point of entry. And here, just by a palpation of a scalp region, we can able to detect the lesion. And if there been a suspicion or otherwise it is yet to be not justified on the point of entry, the area near to the hair area or the point of suspect to be cleared, the hair over that part to be shaved properly, and a proper examination, we can make out the point of entry. And in cases, there are again, right, there are other cases where point of entry may be seen on part of a mouth, either on the part of a tongue or any other oral mucosa may be the point of entry, right? And here the reason may be, right, it could be of an accidental, and most commonly it could be of a child or an insane person, where an alive wire has been caught between mouth and it has produced a point of entry, could be also seen in mouth. And other sites, rare sites, could be of even part of a lower limb, and other sites where a point of entry we need to look for. And in histology, where on a histological examination, when a part has been subjected for examination, the characteristic histological findings may be of epidermis will be elevated, and there will be formation of micro blisters underlying layers and underlying epithelium, and cells have been separated and forming a sharp slits, and palisading or a streaming appearance of nuclei can be seen, and a collagen stain blue, and in ordinary hematoxin eosin staining, and the nuclear of vascular medium have been twisted or appearing to be spiral in shape, and in vascular intima, tearing of elastic fibers and overlying injuries or part of intima can be seen. And other methods by which an entry wound can be subjected for further examination could be of histochemical microprobe analyzer, scanning electron microscope or on a spectroscopy examination, stereomicroscopic examination, and other scanning electron microscope with an energy dispensive x-rays are the other ways by which an entry wound can be subjected and can be opened regarding entry and exit, or there been a suspect or an query on a point of morphological autopsy during morphological autopsy. Right, coming to a second type of injury. Right, so far we have discussed about Joule burns. Now we enter into flash or otherwise spark burns or otherwise exogenous burns. And spark or flash burn is typically produced in high voltage currents, especially high voltage currents are mostly used in for industrial purposes. Right, a point of difference between Joule burn and flash burns is Joule burns occur in low voltage currents in household supplies, but flash or spark burns occurs in industrial sources, and it produces classical melting of keratin of the part of skin over multiple small areas, and there will be a gaps between or otherwise based on the amount of current that has been traveled or sparked over the part of the individual. It may be uniform together and appear like a uniform injury. And on cooling, the molten keratin may fuse together and form a multiple hard brownish nodules on the part of the skin. And this is a classical picture of it appears almost like a crocodile skin. And the other photograph, right? The other photograph and appears like elevated brownish nodules has been seen. It appears like a crocodile skin, brownish nodules, brownish blackish nodules have been seen. As patches and as flesh, there been a localized peeling of skin over the part. Another characteristic feature as a result of a flash burn is arc eye, and here an electrical arc that produces an intense heat as well as UV light emission, and clinically it presents as a superficial painful keratitis, and if an individual survives for a period of greater than 6 to 8 hours, then he suffers from intense bilateral accumulation, blepharospasm or photophobia. Right, and classically seen when an individual survives after a period of 6 to 8 hours after an exposure. And here in case, this again can be even detected in case of a dead individual, and where dead individual will not complain of these signs and symptoms. Instead, with the help of fluorescein staining of both eyes, the living as well as the dead can be stained with fluorescein staining, and where we can able to relieve, it reveals many punctate erosions on the part of cornea. Again, so this is a classical finding and seen as a result of flash or otherwise spark burn. Injury seen on part of entry is electrical splits. Right? Electrical splits can manifest as an incised as well as a lacerated wound, and the shapes may vary. Right? It may be round, oval, linear, or it forms an irregular shape, and skin over the part may be shedded, and some of this may be even attached to the part of a conductor, and wrinkling may be seen on the part of site of entry. And in exit, electrical mark, where there will be maximum injury when comparatively to one entry mark, and there will be more tissue damages seen in point of exit. And this is another photo which shows characteristic exit marks on the part of the sole. Point of exit. Point of exit extensively damaged, right? Extensively local tissue damage is being seen. And other external findings that can be seen in an individual are the face appears pale and eyes appears congested, pupils appear dilated, and rigor mortis appears early, and postmortem lividity will develop over the dependent parts. Seminal ejaculation can occur as a result of contraction of seminal vesicles during the current flow through the body. Secondary burns may or may not be present. And here, if there has been an increased resistance, then obviously an amount of current that has been passed can result in secondary burnings. And charring of the body and amputations of extremities are classically seen in high tension electrocution injuries. And in internal findings, almost all visceral organs, almost all internal organs will show features of congestion, petechial hemorrhages seen along the line of passage of current, brain may show features of irregular tears, fissures are seen, and especially muscles and tendons will show sinkers, degeneration and release of myoglobin within the muscle tissue. And especially skeletal muscles in the path of current, they appear as a severe glassy and hyaline degeneration of the skeletal muscles can result in zinker degeneration. And grossly, the muscle may appear pale and friable, and on microscopical examinations, muscle fibers may appear swollen, and there have been loss of cross striations, and will show features of hyaline membrane appearances. And the underlying vascular structures shows ruptures and as well as small pinpoint hemorrhages are been seen within the muscle layer or underlying tissue layer. Second point, towards release of myoglobin, right? It resembles a crush syndrome, right? And a crush syndrome, again, a video has been posted. Here you can able to see a link below in your description section. And if you want to know what are the features relating to release of myoglobin into the vascular system, where the other name is crush syndrome, and the link has been provided, and you can watch it. Bones and joints can show features of five characteristic features. First and foremost, bone pulse, necrosis of bone, fractures, electrical injury of a part of a skull, and subluxation of major joints. And here, as a result of passage of high voltage current, and there have been a local heat that has been generated, and the current flow melts the bone calcium phosphate. And when individual bones have been examined by x-rays, we can able to see wax dribblings or otherwise bony pearls on part of x-ray. And here non morphological examination, it appears like in a pea like structure or on a small pinpoint clump are seen on part of bones. And second, as a result of necrosis of bone, again another dreaded complication. And third, fractures can be seen, especially fractures of upper limb is classically seen because the most point of entry being upper limb, and upper limb are more frequently been fractured. Fractures of head of humerus, head of neck of humerus, ulna or the other long bones can show fractures, and even bones of lower limb, especially neck of femur, can go for a fracture. And in case of electrical injury over part of skull, and if there been a point of contact being the scalp region, and here as a result of high voltage current that has been passed into the underlying structures, where skull may split open and the orbital contents may be extruded out from the sockets, or even the boiling temperature and formation of steam within the skull are the other possible explanation where on a skull can, even in extreme forces, it can even decapitation injuries can also occur. And in subluxation of joints, most commonly shoulder joints are the most common joints that can go for subluxation. Examination of heart here on gross focal necrosis, the size of hemorrhage is variable and most commonly seen on surface of heart, especially anterior as well as on the posterior surface of heart. And contraction bands can be seen over part of myocardium as well as on conduction system. And local necrosis will be the other associated findings that have been seen on external or the morphological examination of the heart. And in case of histopathological findings, where fragmentation, ruptures, twisting of myofibers can be seen, and interstitial edema and associated with foci of colligative necrosis also demonstrated on histopathological examination. And coming to vascular structures, where microscopic lesions have been seen in vascular media, and in intima, where there will be relatively protected due to the cooling effect of the blood, where in cases where the vessel, entire length of the vessel may show massive coagulation necrosis, and in extreme cases where there have been associated hemorrhages and thrombosis, it can even the emboli or the thrombi can emboli, and it can manifest as a thromboembolism, and these are other associated causes of death in case of electrocution. And again, these are delayed causes of death that can occur as a result of electrocution. And here come other organs like kidney and urine. And here in urine, due to the crush syndrome or due to release of myoglobulins in the circulation, where even deposits of myoglobin can be detected in part of urine, and lower nephrons may show features of nephrosis as a result of myoglobin entering and destructing the renal nephrons, and features of nephrosis will be the other associated finding. And relating, coming to the others, like the cause of death in case of electrocution, where the first and foremost immediate cause could be of a ventricular fibrillation and tetanic asphyxia, respiratory arrest, cardiac arrest, cerebral anoxia, and secondary burns as a result of ingestion of the cloth can result in burns, thermal injuries. And seventh, as a result of secondary injuries, right? And according to the base of the current, grounding, and the amount of voltage of current that has been passed, multiple fractures can occur, or even in extreme cases where an individual may be thrown from the site and he may sustain multiple injuries as a result of impact over the nearby structures at the scene of crime. And in case of medical legal import towards electrocution, where accidental deaths can occur and they are more common and more fatal in nature while working either in household or in industrial workspace. And second, suicidal, there have been cases reported, and in cases where homicidal as a result of childhood abuse or a form of any electronic torture methods, where an electrocution can be even a homicidal in nature. And judicial electrocution in Western countries, where it been a practice as a punishment of capital punishment in past and in present in some countries. And as a child abuse has been discussed. Point number 7, autoerotic electrocution, right? And a sexually perverted individual may apply electric supply as an a stimulus, where in extreme cases, where due to the flow of current or due to the passage of current in a larger quantity, can be even fatal. Again, it could be fits into an accidental causes of electrocution. If there have been any doubt, queries relating to the content of the video, kindly address those in comment section below, or otherwise address through any of the social media links that has been provided in description section. Thank you so much.